Abdulrahman Aljiffry. I'm the Accelerator Manager at the King Abdullah University of Science and Technology Entrepreneurship Center. I'm also the Chairman of the Board of the Abqad Western Region Angel Investor Network. I've been investing for the past 2 years. I've been supporting founders for the past 10. And what mainly drew me to the fellowship was the focus on impact. COVID has really taught us that there's a clear difference between what is and isn't essential. And instead of taking an opportunistic lens at the startup investing and the ecosystem, it's refreshing to see it from more of an impact point of view, not purely just impact investing to save the world, but also to succeed and show that there's a marriage to both of these. So I'm really excited to be part of that community. Common misconception is angel investors are these individual, solo, straight shooters who immediately just decide on the spot to invest. Whereas the best angel investors I know are very communal. They work with others, they collaborate with other investors, and they know that that's key to kind of building a long-term portfolio. And I think the fellowship and startAD's and VSQ's Angel Rising, along with KAUST and other partners, is a key part of that. You know, investors, especially in this day and age, need high quality ways to interact with other investors, share notes, share deals, work together so that they can help build a portfolio. And being able to discuss, compare, you know, this company with that company, and this provides that with a unique perspective on impact investing, on things that are actually important to food, to financial inclusion, to health, to education. So it's putting that specific group of like-minded people together tends to help create that nice resonance amongst all of them. And it will, I believe, help them to, you know, deliver real, real, tangible, long-lasting impact. And predictions are always, it's always a dangerous word. I mean, so many people have fallen flat on their face trying to kind of predict the future. But as investors and founders to a larger extent, you know, we always have to take a stab at what the future might bring. I think generally, if I was to look at for the region, angel investing is still pretty nascent. There's a lot of new talent coming into the angel investing game. There's more understanding of the startup ecosystem. So I'm expecting a rapid maturing of the angel investor community. I'm also expecting a lot of influx to come in with excitement into startups as an asset class. So I'm expecting to see a lot of tough lessons to those who kind of go it out, who don't partake in working with other investors or experienced, who kind of just go with gut feel. Startups are very fashionable, and that tends to drive a lot of dangerous decisions. And I think all of my worst mistakes, my most expensive mistakes, were ones that I made as an individual. So I'm expecting a lot of people to encounter a couple of bumps in the road, but also a sharp increase in sophistication. So much more angel networks and syndicates, people starting to, after doing a few deals individually, starting to kind of talk to other angel investors, create these syndicates, and we might see the emergence of these, angels with really strong networks that are almost super angels that might creep into VC category. It's a trend that we saw a couple of years ago, and I'm expecting to see that happen in MENA at a rapid pace. So I think the biggest takeaway from the program that comes to me frequently is there was a point in the program where we focused on input. And I think a lot of the language around investing is about evaluating, about seeing who the best founders are, what their traits, how to look at markets, how to look at timing. But pausing to look at input, at what I as an investor am going to put into a startup to add value, to change their trajectory, to improve things, it was an important exercise. And it forced me to look inwards of how do I want to support founders? How can I be more systematic about that? And it forced me to think about being a bit more structured in that regard, instead of saying, okay, when the founder needs me or in board meetings or any other times, I'll be there. Instead, I actually look at making myself more productized, more structured, more independent in terms of this is what I'll do, more proactive. So that was the biggest takeaway of looking at what am I going to give to these startups? What is the impact of that on the startup? And what is the knock-on effect of that on the broader ecosystem? I thought that was super insightful and very, very useful to me. The biggest change would be more information. I think the maturity of the ecosystem will increase the more data we have, the more information is out there. Compared to other regions, sometimes you get a lot of rounds that are confidential, investors don't want to be known, valuations aren't disclosed, round sizes aren't disclosed. And, you know, if you compare that with other ecosystems, you find that, you know, over time, it's really hard to make really fair valuation discussions because of the lack of information. I think increased transparency would be the biggest thing I want, where people are more willing to publicly talk about their investments, what they're excited about, what their position is. So investors being more open with what their thesis is something I'd love to see more of, and being more open with, you know, this is the round, this is the size, just so that the market becomes a lot more efficient. There is more information out there. Entrepreneurs aren't picking, you know, valuations, grasping at straws to come up with what feels like a fair number. So that would be the thing that I think would most immediately make my life a lot easier.